onto the Murad Matte Effect Blotting Perfector. This retails for $39 and you get 0.4 ounces of product, so you do get a tiny bit less in this product than the NYX one. This is exclusive to Sephora and it is actually a compact product, so it's just like a cushion foundation. You guys will see during the application and everything my thoughts on the packaging. So it says it's a translucent liquid blotting formula in an on-the-go cushion compact that instantly mattifies skin, absorbs oil, visibly minimizes pores, and perfects. This unique formula dries quickly and provides a touchable softness to the skin while perfecting the look of skin. It says after 8 hours it's supposed to keep the skin mattified and keeps the appearance of pores minimized. I do have pretty big pores, so we'll also see what it does to my pores. 8 hours isn't that long, so I'm hoping that my face is going to stay mattified for longer than that. I typically do 10-hour wear tests. You can use this underneath your makeup as a primer, or you can also touch up throughout the day by just applying this on the parts of your face that are oily, and it's supposed to help mattify, and I'm going to need a lot of these today. All right, so let's go ahead and clip back the hair. So I think we're going to do the Murad Blotting Perfector on this side of my face and then the NYX Shine Killer on the other side. I've already washed and moisturized my face. Obviously, have not primed yet. Super light. Packaging feels pretty plasticky. Yeah, this is a pretty cheap feeling compact. I'm definitely going to use this as a primer on the bottom, and then I might try like a portion of my face on top of the foundation just so we can see if it's different if you have to put on foundation too. So I just peeled this up. Normally with cushion products, there's a sealant that you peel off to keep it from drying out. And I don't see a sealant on here. So that's interesting. No sealant. You get like a liquidy light pink consistency. I'm gonna attempt to do half my nose with this. Doesn't really have a scent. And it feels nice and cooling. Actually, it feels really good. Ooh. And I'm just kind of pressing this on like a normal cushion product. I think that half of my face is sufficiently covered. Ooh, whoa, it feels like a powder almost. It's super soft. I'd say it takes about 20 seconds to dry down, and it does look more matte for sure than this side, especially on my forehead. My pores definitely look smaller on this side right now. I'm gonna zoom you guys in. So hopefully you can see this. Here are my pores on this side. My pores on this side do look a tiny bit smaller to me. So it is 10:27 right now, so we're going to call the check-in time 10:30. I'm not going to be applying a powder today because I want to see how the primers control the oil, not the powder. So I'm going to do the rest of my makeup, and I will be right back. All right, so it's now, exactly 11 o'clock. There you go. So the rest of my makeup's on. I'm going to tell you guys everything that's on my face in a second. Blending out blush, bronzer, highlight. I do feel like this side blended out super easily. It felt like I was blending on top of a powder, even though I haven't powdered my face. I'm trying to decide if I want to put part of this over my face right now. And I think it might make most sense to wait until the next check-in, because if I put it on right now, I think I'm just gonna look dry. My forehead looks a little bit dry on both sides, but a little bit more on this side right now. So I'm gonna give my skin a chance to produce some oil, and then we'll see if this kind of mattifies it. So it is 4:30, so everything has been on for 6 hours now. So I'm filming on the iPhone right now. I hope I'm not covering the speaker, actually. But it's on the 4K video app, so it should be okay quality to see everything. So both sides to me right now are looking pretty much identical. There might be a little bit more dew coming through on my forehead on the NYX side. Actually, it looks a little bit more matte on this side around my nose, but everything else I think is looking pretty similar. And I do have the kitchen light on right now, so that's the light that you're seeing right there. Oh, should I blot it? I'm gonna blot at the end of the night if I have some oil, but let's just see how it holds up with these two. All right, so it's now 10:08, so it's been on for almost 12 hours. This is a super long check-in, and I have some thoughts. So this side of my face definitely is more oily to me than NYX Shine Killer side. This side is oily on my forehead too. Keep in mind that I have a light on, so it's reflecting off of it. But in the mirror, this side definitely looks more oily overall. This is way more mattified, and around my nose area especially is where I see a difference. My chin looks really bad on both sides. I don't know what it is, but I feel like I majorly broke out today, kind of on both sides all over. I mean, I have some major new acne down here today, and it also looks very separated on my chin. And then here, my pores look pretty large and super shiny. And as you can see, this side is more mattified. It doesn't look great still, like it still looks a little bit caked up around my nose. But this side for sure looks better around my nose area. I feel like that's a huge difference right there. Forehead, I think, looks about the same on both sides. So overall thoughts, This side, I feel like really didn't do anything for my oil. This side, I do like how it mattified around my nose area. Since you can apply this over the product, we're going to try that out. I'm going to do the NYX Shine Killer and the Murad on top just to see if you're someone who does like blotting throughout the day, to see if this would kind of mattify. So I'm just going to go on the forehead first because that's where I have most oil right now. And I don't know how this isn't going to take off my foundation. So that definitely mattified. You can see on here it came off a little bit, but yeah, it's back to like that powdery kind of finish. Do it around my nose. This area is still pretty matte on my cheeks. I'm gonna do my chin. I do feel like it's taking off some of the product, but compared to this side, I mean, that totally mattified it, especially on the forehead. Not bad. I probably wouldn't put this on top of a foundation just because I don't want it to take off anything, but I do like it for underneath foundation, especially if you just concentrate it on your oily areas.